this group's very special on and off the court. I got to know them personally, and these group of girls are just really special and goofy. I was really shy coming into my first year, and they got me out of my comfort zone, and ever since now, I really love hanging out with them, and it's been a great time. I knew when she called the timeout, she said she was going to honor me, and I just didn't want to leave the court, and I wish I can still play competitively, and I didn't see this day coming so soon, and it's just really sad. I've been sad since our LA trip, because that was our last travel trip, me traveling with the team, and then I came into the other game with a career high in today's game, and I knew it was the last game I'd step on the court as a student athlete.
You know, that was a tough moment. I just, you know, it felt really good to hug Sharon, and as I just told the team, and I've told Sharon that, you know, she's left her mark here with our program, and, you know, there's certain things that us coaches look for in players to really instill the culture that we have here with our women's basketball program, and I don't think there's a better example than Sharon. As I just told her, she is really everything that we look for as far as just her coachability, her work ethic, her commitment. And I'm not just talking about on the court. She's the same exact way off the court when it comes to the classroom. And I said this earlier, and I mean this in a complimentary way, is, you know, things don't come easy for Sharon. And I say that because she's a self-made student athlete. And what I mean by that is the time and the commitment that she puts into everything that she does is exactly why she has the success that she has. And, you know, here she is going into, she's been accepted to grad school at Cal Baptist. And I just know Sharon's going to be successful. You know, she's going into the physical therapy field, and I know she's going to be successful in everything that she does because that's who she is. And she's been an absolute joy for Coach Bloss and I to coach. And I think she's been a tremendous example. She was the only one on this roster who had Division II experience. And so that's just from an experience and talent standpoint. But once I learned Sharon last year, who she is as a person and who she is, just her character, I think she's just been a tremendous example for the rest of the girls on the team. Everybody was kind of thrown into the fire this year, and due to a number of different circumstances. And although there was just so many bumps in the road and a lot of adversity this year, I can't help but think the experience, the game minutes that they all received this year can only help going into next year. Obviously, we're losing Sharon, and there's a lot of pieces that we have to fill, which we will. But those, five that are returning, just the experience that they gained from this year, you know, hopefully it's a great deal. They need to mature, and they need to move forward as far as who they are as students and athletes and people, and just become much better next year, and I'm confident that they will do that. Well, you know, to the fans, to be honest, I feel like I owe an apology. You know, I was brought here at Humboldt State, and I'm a winner, and I know that's what the expectations are from whatever program I run. And, you know, normally my teams overachieve, and obviously our record is not indicative of what these girls went through. However, I do feel like we underachieved in certain areas too. And so, you know, here we are of all years, the conference tournament is here in Lumberjack Arena, and it's, to be quite frank, it's embarrassing, and I feel like we've let the community down by not being participants in the tournament. And so from that standpoint, I feel like I owe an apology to the fans. And all I can say is we got to continue to work here really hard in the off season and be much better next year. I'm just really happy for Sharon. I mean, I know we didn't get the wins these two games here at home, but she just left her heart and soul out on the floor on Thursday night, obviously coming away with her career high. And then tonight, no, she didn't score the points that she did Thursday night, but it's always the same. I've told her all year, I know exactly what I'm going to get from her. And that's her heart and soul, and she just leaves it all out there. So I'm really proud, even though we didn't come out with the wins, that she was able to really kind of display who she is in front of everybody. And I think, Sharon, you should be very, very proud of what you've done for this program, and just a big thank you to Sharon.
They helped me both on and on the court. Coach Bloss especially, he would work around my work schedule too. I would always ask him, hey, can you open the gym at 7 or 8 a.m.? He would always come no matter what. And Coach B, I'm so happy that I played her in the preseason a couple years ago, because if that never happened, I wouldn't be here. And I'm so happy she accepted me into this Lumberjack family, and I can't thank her enough.